Hello and welcome. You're watching Property Hotline with me, Kavita Krishnan, on Magicbricks Now. So if you are planning to buy, sell or invest in property and you are wondering whether you're taking the right decision, whether you're getting yourself a good deal, you've tuned into the right show because this is a show where we get expert answers, where we empower you to take the right decisions. Today we'll be answering questions, like I said, relating to buying, selling and investing in property. Our expert for the day is Jayashree Kurup. Jayashree is the head of content and research at magicbricks.com and she joins me from Delhi. Jayashree, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Let's get started, Jayashree. We have a question that's come in on email. Pratik Dalvi has written in. He says that he has a shop in Airoli, Navi Mumbai in Sector 8, which is 440 square feet in size. Now, he bought it in 2004 for 1,800 rupees per square foot. He wants to know if he should hold it or he should sell it. He also wants to know if he should invest in a residential property in upcoming markets like Ulve, Panvel or Dronagiri. His budget would be as per the amount he receives from selling the shop. And obviously, this is for investment purpose. So what should he do, hold, sell, and where should he reinvest whatever he gets from selling the property?
See, this is a problem that a lot of buyers have today. In fact, I feel the market is actually flooded with buyers. But those buyers want to sell first and then buy. And this is not a good market for selling property. So it's like, can I offset the not so high returns that I get out of selling property into buying a property at a cheaper rate when I buy? And that is, you can't sell at the highest rates and buy at the lowest rates, right? So this is a classic problem that most people have. Now, it's like this. Rental returns of commercial property are generally higher than that of residential property. What he has done is bought a small commercial property, and if the returns are around 5-6%, that which is what I suspect you would get, a lot of buyers of commercial property are not getting even that 5-6% today. If you're not getting anything, don't think twice. I think it's a good idea to exit from that and get into residential property because you'll get it at the best rates. And that is the rule of the thumb. Wherever you can get at lowest rates, pick it up. The second thing I would say is one BHK of about 350 square feet. I checked on Magicbricks and I found that a 350 square feet in Panvel is available at about 8.5 lakh onwards, while a one BHK of about 300 square feet is available for about 8 lakh onwards around in Dronagiri. Now, if you sell your property, you would get a little higher than what you're looking for. So I would say, If you are not getting a good rental return in your commercial property, it is a good idea to sell and buy in Dronagiri or Panvel. You're looking at way outside the city, but these are areas where you can invest today. They are in early stages of construction. If you are getting good commercial returns and you're getting regular rental returns, I would say hold on to your commercial property for a little while longer, because these areas may only rise very steadily and not dramatically, so you may be able to afford it a little into the future as well. So if you're getting good rental returns, hold it, because in these new areas, you may not get a very good rental return for a while.
Right. Jayashree, before we move on, if you could just break this down for Pratik and for the other viewers also, since you're talking commercial property here, what constitutes a good rental return? What is a basic rule of thumb over here?
When it is a shop, you would say 5-6% is what you get, unless it is in a really high demand area where per square foot rental rates are very, very high, and which is not the kind of properties that we normally get in these queries. If you have bought a small commercial property and you get about 5-6%, which means that you're getting a regular rental return from somebody, you invested something and you're able to get something out of it, I would say that is a good enough reason for you to hold in a weak real estate market. The market is likely to pick up, but it'll take at least another year and a half for this market to pick up. And when you, little later, if you sell, you will be able to get better, slightly better rates than what you get today.
So So Prateek, the verdict is hold if you can, and especially if you're getting at least 5 to 6% of your capital value as rental, then you would be better off holding and then investing, you know, selling it and reinvesting that money probably a year, year and a half down the line. Let's move on. Colonel Rahul Puri has called in. Colonel Puri, tell us what's your question.
Good evening. I'm calling from Gurgaon. You see, my question pertains to the city of Bhiwadi.
Okay.
Now, there is a company by the name of Terra City, mm-hmm. which has come up with a site for residential plots, that is Terra City 2. It is not very far away from the Honda plant in Bhiwadi, and about 2 kilometers it is behind the Siegberg plant, Siegberg factory.
Okay.
That is the village Bibipur. Now, that's the landmark for you is basically just 2 kilometers the other side of the Honda plant in Bhiwadi. Now, my question is, plots were sold here at about 15,000 rupees per square yard about 2 years back. So I want to know, what is the growth potential of that area and how much time would it take? How much time would an investor require to hold the plot there?
Okay, right. Jayashree, Colonel Puri's question here, he's looking at plots in Bhiwadi. He wants to know what is the growth prospects. Now, this is also the area where the airport is going to come up. So he should see decent growth over here, right?
Yeah, right. There are two things that you should remember here. Your property value has not appreciated at all. It's still around 15,000-16,000 rupees a square yard. So it's not like your property value has appreciated, but this and the livability quotient that our users give when it comes to, you know, they rate localities. So this locality, the users have given a livability rating of 2.8 out of 5, which means that it's very early in its stages of development. Now, what are the future prospects? There are two things that you should consider. One, there is a big infrastructure project coming up. When the DMIC comes, this will be very close to the DMIC, and that will be a big driver. You also know that right now it is the factory demand that is driving this, and it's not a very big demand as of now, and there is enough supply around that area. On the Alwar Bypass Road, once the infrastructure projects get going, and that will be at least 3, 4, 5 years into the future, you should be getting much better returns. So if you've held it so far, I would say, unless you need the money, then you exit and you're not gaining anything, you're not losing anything. But if you do buy, if you are planning to hold for at least 5 to 7 years, you should be able to get better returns.
So, Colonel Puri, have you already bought this? Do you plan to exit it? What is the status right now?
You see, I bought it and I'm holding. You see, the possession is likely this year, sometimes this year,
mm-hmm.
maybe the middle of the year. We only paid about 18, 19 lakhs. Another 3, 4, 5 lakhs have yet to be paid.
Okay.
So, a lot of people, you see, they have varied views. And I think what Jayashree just mentioned, I think she's right because DMIC is coming up and, you see, and there's even a Japanese zone in Neemrana. So all that kind of airport, what you mentioned, I think all that is going to take an effect. But 5 to 7 years, what she says, yes, it's a long period, but I think, I mean, I'll have to see the market.
Right, but Colonel Puri, you need to consider this, that real estate is a patient asset, you know. You need to hold it for a minimum of 5 years to actually get good returns on that investment that you made. And since you've anyway waited so long, you might as well just wait. Take full advantage of the infrastructure boom that is coming into that place and then exit that particular investment, right?
Yeah.
Thank you so much for calling in.
Very kind of you, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Moving on, we have a question coming in from Rajiv Singh. He's written in on our website, www.mbnow.in. Rajiv has booked a 1 BHK flat in Zambul Nagar near Kanhe Junction, Vadgaon, Talegaon in Pune. Name of the project is Zerbia Abode. He is looking at it for a 15-year investment and wants to know about this area's future prospects. Jayashree, what would you say? I know that Exurbia is a massive affordable housing project that is coming up in this area. But what kind of appreciation do you actually see over here? Because affordable housing, by its very definition, has a cap on the price.
Right. Let me take Talegaon first. I think Talegaon is an area where you have seen very, you know, the base was very, very low. It was, it started about 3 to 5 years ago. And you've seen in the last 3, 4 years, about 20 to 30% rise in values, which really means that development is on and there is some amount of user interest. Now, Zerbia is, as you said, a very large project, and being an affordable housing project, it is its value is going to be capped for 5 years. If you anyone who enters an affordable housing project, as the government of India is launching across states now, has to remember that one, it is going to be a small unit. Therefore, when you sell, you won't have a big problem selling it, but you can't sell it for 5 years. You're locked into the affordable housing scheme for 5 years, which means that you're going to remain invested for 5 years. It's a small unit, therefore your entry cost is not very high. Since these are new projects and these have not been in the market so far, I don't have any yardstick to tell you how much it will appreciate in the future. It really depends on what the prospects of that locality are. Now, Talegaon has a lot of drivers. The fact that it has risen by about 30% in the last 3-4 years shows that there is definite interest in Talegaon. And because there is also a manufacturing hub nearby, which is, you know, as the manufacturing sector picks up, which we expect in the next 2 years or so, this will drive the demand for smaller housing. And that is what will feed into where you are invested. So I would say hold this project, and you've got a 15-year horizon. You can't go wrong on that. Just be patient and hang on to the project.
Right, Rajiv, you've got a 15-year horizon. You really can't go wrong with that in real estate. The prices right now in Talegaon are averaging around 3,705 rupees per square foot. And Jayashree said, you've already seen quite a bit of run-up in the prices over here. So hold on and make good on that investment. Let's move on. Ravinder Kumar has called in. Ravinder, tell us what's your question.
Madam, I am Ravinder, speaking from Delhi. Mm-hmm. Madam, I am holding a 250 square yard plot in Faridabad, Nairpar area, sector 84.
Okay.
Madam, I purchased this plot in the year 2010 and for investment purpose. Now, my question is whether I should continue to hold it, number one, or if it will be better for me to go for a flat in Gurgaon or Noida, Greater Noida area. What will be better for me?
Okay, so you would be looking at selling this plot and going into either Gurgaon or Greater Noida, right?
Yeah, I would be looking for that. Even if I have to put some additional money, and I can invest up to approximately 1.25 crore. Whether I will get this...
Okay, Ravinder, this is 1.25 crore over what you will get from selling that plot?
That will not be... I will have to put some additional money from my side. I will get some about 65 to 70 lakhs from that, plot.
Okay.
Additional money I will...
You can add on to that. Okay. What do you say, Jayashree? He wants to know whether he should hold this plot or whether he's better off selling in Neherpar and buying in, Gurgaon or Noida. He's willing to add some money from his pocket and stretch the budget to 1.25 crore.
See, the Neherpar area is something that has actually not taken off like it should have. Neherpar was planned in 2004-2005, and many sectors were planned. This should have taken off by this time. Unfortunately, for various reasons, the government was slow in developing the external infrastructure, and the developers on their part did not do do their own work. So the entire area has been extremely slow, and its prospects are way into the future. Now, since you've bought that property, I checked out what you can get today. And like you said, something between 48 and 75 lakhs, depending on the location of your unit and so on. There are many factors that impact the price of your property. But roughly, this is in this range is what you'll get, roughly 65 to 70 lakhs or a little more if your property is very premium in that locality. That is what you will get. Now, if you exit that and you're considering putting in some more money and buying a residential built-up unit. Now, when you buy a plot, an apartment, you today the values have been at rock bottom in Gurgaon, in Greater Noida and so on. If you're buying in Noida or Greater Noida, I think you will be able to get something very close to what you're getting for this value. 75, 80, 85 lakhs, you should be able to get comfortably get a good apartment in this price bracket without putting in too much of your own. In Gurgaon, you'll have to put a little more than that, but values have never been this low in Gurgaon. And I think once the tide turns, Gurgaon's intrinsic worth, because all the Fortune 500 companies have their corporate offices in Gurgaon, the intrinsic worth of Gurgaon is very high. So you will see that the amount of rental returns you get will be a little higher in Gurgaon in the future. Today the markets are down, and today it is not like you're going to get a huge rental return on that property. But you do get some. If you hold your plot in Neherpar, on the other hand, though the metro has come into Faridabad, we are not sure how long it will take for Neherpar to grow. It was supposed to be one of the smart cities. It has been a contender for more funds. But funds were never its problem. It was also flush with cash when the JNNURM happened, and it was the one city that got the maximum JNNURM funds after Mumbai. But I don't think its development has matched, kept pace with what its potential was. So I would say that is in the future. If you do want to reinvest, this is a good time to exit if you can find a good buyer and reinvest in an apartment.
Okay, now that's a piece of advice. Jayashree has not really been given to too many callers, too many of the viewers who call in on our show. Ravinder, good time to exit your investment in Neherpar. Sell if you're getting a good price. Take the money and invest. Reinvest it either in Gurgaon or in Greater Noida like you've planned. Jayashree, before we get into a break, I just wanted to, check this, because we're getting a lot of these questions, and it also looks like a lot of our viewers right now are in the market to upgrade. Now, would you suggest, that they wait till they find a good buyer for their existing flat and then look to upgrade? Or should they just go ahead, take a home loan if they can afford it, buy that new flat and then look for a good time, probably wait for a year or so and then sell their existing flats or properties when the market becomes a little better?
Kavita, whoever can afford to put in money today, take a loan and start buying a new property today, and then wait for the tide to turn, let the markets improve, and then sell, will get the best value for that property. But like I said, the reason why I said sell in Neherpar is because Neherpar is not going to, the tide is not going to turn very fast. It's really very early in its stages of development, and for any logical returns, he'll have to wait a long time, by which time the property markets in the rest of the areas would have changed. So therefore, if you have to assess, where do you hold the property? If you think that place, the potential of growth is good for in the next 1 to 1.5 years, hold your investment, try and make a new investment wherever you want, and then sell in this place if you want to, when the markets are better. But if you feel that the prospects of the current property that you hold is not very good, it's a good idea to find a buyer, exit fast, and make a clean break.
Right. So while on the whole, if it's not a great time for you to be selling property, but if you are stuck in a market that is going nowhere, it's best to find a buyer and exit that property. Next, we have a viewer who's called in. Tell us what's your name and what's your question, sir. Hello? Hello, can you hear me?
I am from Chandrapur, Maharashtra.
Hello?
I am from Chandrapur, Maharashtra.
Yes, tell me what's your name.
K. Sugnakar.
Mr. Sugnakar, tell us what's your question.
Madam, I had to book a flat in Nagpur for investment purpose.
ठीक है.
तो मैंने दो शॉर्ट लिस्ट किया था, दो डेवलपर का, एक पिरामिड सिटी एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज अथर्वा डेवलपर टुवर्ड्स द एंटायर मेट्रो पार्क.
किधर है नागपुर में?
एंटायर मेट्रो पार्क,
हाँ राइट राइट राइट, गो ऑन.
बेसा पिपला रोड. मैंने दो शॉर्ट लिस्ट किया था, एक पिरामिड एंड नेक्स्ट वन इज अथर्वा डेवलपर.
हाँ जी, आपका बजट क्या है, कितने में आप खरीदना चाहते हैं यहाँ पर फ्लैट?
मेरा बजट जो है मैडम 25 to 35 लाख.
एग्जैक्ट. ठीक है, तो जयश्री, इन्होंने दो प्रोजेक्ट शॉर्टलिस्ट किए हैं नागपुर में, पिरामिड सिटी एंड अथर्व डेवलपर्स एनसारा मेट्रो पार्क के पास. नागपुर इज द ज्योग्राफिक सेंटर ऑफ द कंट्री, एक्सपेक्टेड टू रियली रियली बेनिफिट वंस जीएसटी कम्स इन. आपको क्या लगता है किस तरह के प्रोस्पेक्ट्स हो सकते हैं नागपुर शहर के लिए और इन प्रॉपर्टीज के लिए?
देखिए, बेसार रोड इफ़ यू लुक एट इट, आपको रफली अबाउट 225 स्क्वायर यार्ड प्रॉपर्टी मिल सकता है 25 लाख के बजट में. यहाँ पे बेसार रोड, आपको पता है यहाँ कनेक्टिविटी अच्छी है और इट इज़ कनेक्टेड टू द सिटी एरियाज एज वेल एज यू नो, ये आउटस्कर्ट्स ऑफ द सिटी में है मगर ये कमर्शियल हब्स के पास में है, तो इसमें अच्छा प्रॉस्पेक्ट है. तो लगभग 225 स्क्वायर यार्ड का प्रॉपर्टी तो आपके बजट में आपको मिल जाएगा. इससे अगर आप 25 लाख से थोड़ा ज़्यादा स्पेंड कर सकते हैं तो 250-275 स्क्वायर यार्ड का प्लॉट आपको मिल सकता है. ये सेकेंडरी मार्केट से आपको मिल सकता है इससे. और नागपुर का बिकॉज इट इज़ अ लॉजिस्टिक्स एंड वेयरहाउसिंग हब और ये सेक्टर काफ़ी अच्छा कर रहा है, तो यहाँ पे गुड प्रॉस्पेक्ट्स हैं इन द फ्यूचर.
राइट मिस्टर सुगनाकर, आपने जो लोकेशन चुना काफ़ी बढ़िया है, शहर के बाहर ज़रूर है लेकिन लोकेशन काफ़ी बढ़िया है. अपने आप एक लॉजिस्टिक्स हब के पास में है. एनसारा मेट्रो पार्क जो है अपने आप में एक लॉजिस्टिक्स हब है. यहाँ पर काफ़ी अच्छे प्रोस्पेक्ट्स हो सकते हैं, खासकर एक बार जब जीएसटी आ जाए तब यहाँ का जो प्रोस्पेक्ट्स है वो और बढ़ सकता है. यहाँ पर आपको काफ़ी बढ़ोतरी देखने को मिल सकती है. नेक्स्ट, राइट, थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर कॉलिंग इन. लेट्स मूव ऑन. वी हैव सुमेर बुद्धिराजा हु इज रिटन थ्रू ईमेल. नाउ सुमेर वांट्स टू इंक्वायर अबाउट अ प्रोजेक्ट कॉल्ड द आम्रपाली आदर्श आवास योजना. He wants to know about future prospects of this project in the time horizon of 5 to 7 years. He wants to know about the builder's reputation and performance in the past, whether it's worth buying a flat on the ground floor for 36.25 lakh rupees plus service tax plus registry charges. Now, Jayashree, we're getting a lot of questions about this particular project. I understand it's been launched with some special schemes for government employees, obviously to tap into the, to the expected boom in demand coming out of the pay commission recommendations. What do you say, should he invest?
There are two, three things that you should consider. Because the markets have been slow, a lot of people want to know if I buy. This is early stages of the project, pretty early stages. And will the project be complete on time? So because we get such a large volume of queries, we decided to do a recce of our own into this project and the developer. Now, let me just quickly take you through the ground realities. This is a developer who has launched a very large number of projects, and this project itself is around 10,000 units. It's huge. So why is he confident that he will be able to deliver? This developer has set up one of the most state-of-the-art prefab construction units in Greater Noida and is capable of building at a very rapid pace because it is prefabricated and the quality of the prefab was assessed by experts who had come with us, and they said that the quality of the prefabricated structure is very good, which means that they can maintain quality and they can maintain speed. As a result, the chances of this project being completed on time is very high. Now, why have they brought it out for government employees? Like Kavita said, because there is a pay commission rise expected, and because of that money, they do know that there will be a little extra money in the wallets of government employees. I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Right, Jayashree, I'm sorry, but we're running out of time. Could you tell us quickly what he should do here? Should he buy or should he, wait for some more time?
I would say that you can buy. This is early stage development and there will be growth in the future.
Right, early stage development, Sumer, but you could see growth in the future. So go in and buy into the project is what Jayashree says. With that, it's a wrap on today's show, Property Hotline. Jayashree, thank you very much for joining in. We'll be back, however, on Tuesday to answer legal queries. Also remember, on Wednesday, we are going to answer all your questions related to housing societies. So if you or your housing society is facing any problems, do call in with your questions. Do send in your questions with us. We will have an expert who will be answering those questions. You know how to reach out to us. You can send in, you can write in to us on email, on Facebook, or on our website. You could also send in video queries to feedback@mbnow.in. You can tweet to me. I would love to hear from you. Or else you can call in like all the other callers you saw on the show tonight. Thank you for tuning in and keep watching Magicbricks Now.